Hey folks, I'm Vixen. Today we're going to play Battle Brothers, a game by Overhype Studio. It is a game in which we're going to manage a company of mercenary, which is going to go from town to town to accomplish contracts and fight bandits and fantastic creatures like undead or goblins. You will be fighting these guys in a turn-based combat. You will be able to level up your guys and give them new equipment. And as the game is just out of early access, I think it's a perfect time to take a look at its current state. So let's just create a new campaign and let's see how fast we're getting today, because the game was pretty tough the last time I've been trying it. So let's just see. We're going to go with beginner. It is going to allow us a bit more flexibility here. We're going to keep things basically normal, I think. I'm going to change my company. It's going to be, let's say, the 7th. Of Odessa here. I'm going to choose a different banner. So where do we want to go for? Do we have something nice? Oh, we could go for the bear. It is quite cool. But do we have other thing? I think we had something. This is pretty grim. We could go with this one. It's a bit menacing, but it might be working well. Oh, let's see, we have something also with... Now let's go for the bear. Yes, it's working fine. And let's just go for it. So this one we don't want to meet right away. We are going to be slaughtered if it is the case. Okay, the last battle. It all went wrong. 2 days ago, the company was hired to track down Hogard the Weasel and his band of raiders, but it was them who found you first. An ambush, some joke about horse, cut short by an arrow to the throat. Arrows shooting in from everywhere and nowhere. Men old and scream, and a great volume before this. As the hell subside, you drown your weapon with the rest of your men, only to collapse to your knees. An arrow has punctured your side. You shoot in pain. At a glance, sees a man charge without you to make a valiant last stand. Met in force as still clash with steel. You meet eyes with the captain, a last nod before his throat is cut. You are left in command now of what few men remain. Trembling in pain, you learn on your sword, and with all the will you can, must slowly rise again. Alright. And let's see. We've got a few enemy remaining. But how many of us are still standing? Less and less, it seems. Brigand, Conrad, Wendell, and Espen. Okay, these are my three guys. They've got crossbows, axe, and spears to defend themselves. And let's just see what we can do. So, do we need to reload something? Or are they just to... Okay, let's take a look. Shoot bolts, and okay, so I'm going to try to, can I know it's too far, so we're going to go for the guy which is going to be taking the most damage. 58% for this one and 52 for this one, but it seems one has no protection to that, so if I was to maybe kill him first would be nice. Okay, almost there, near death. He might bail. So we're going to... We are not going to be able to shoot again, are we? Load. I got 2 points, so done. And I'm going to go and meet that guy with my spear. So let's just advance a bit. Just... No, maybe a bit too far. I'll just go over there. And we're going to go in a defensive mode. I think I can probably use my shield wall to... spear wall. But I'm going to also... let's see. 4 AP and 4... This one is going to take 4 as well, so I cannot do both. I'm going to go with the spear wall here. If they get any closer, they're going to get damaged. So let's just end the turn for that guy. Or I could just maybe switch to the other. Let's just go for... Alright, so that guy here is going to advance a bit. And going to enter in the opponent control zone, so we might take a bit of damage here. Alright, here we go. And now we're going to go for, let's see... Split shield? Yes, no shield. So we're going to go for a regular splitman attack. Which we failed. And do I want to advance a bit more? Not really, let's just stick to that. Oh, not cool. Oh, not cool. Okay, he failed the first one, but not the second one. And where is Bowman? I think he left. Okay, mine is ready, but he won't be able to shoot anybody, I think. Or maybe he will. I could finish that guy. I don't want to eat my people, so let's just be careful. And if I just run out of the way, I might be in trouble. Okay, let's try to kill him. Okay, it's working fine. Let's just reload. And then. So now I could just maybe try to kill the guy here. Or I could just fall back a bit, but it might be trouble for me. Let's just try it nonetheless. Oh crap, I failed. Okay, bad idea. Let's just try to kill him. Okay, no more helmet. And no more plate as well. So let's just see. Can I go toward him? Close enough. Quick enough so I don't get any issue. Okay, let's try to finish him. Okay, we are fine. Nobody died. We've got a bit of XP for everybody. Espen and Wendell took more because they actually managed to let a kill. And let's just take a look at the loot. So we've got a wooden flail. It's important to pick up stuff because weapons tend to decay, kind of. Alright. And having a few spare ones is always good. So you're alive, you won. So adrenaline fade in and in it wakes, you can help but sink back to the ground. Gritting your teeth, you snap the arrow's shaft. Your chest heaves, painful breaths. Everything blurs. The company has been devastated. Cut down to but a few men. And that bastard Hogarth did justice to his name, fleeing like the weasel he is. So we need to catch the bowman. What now, Captain? A voice say from behind. It's Conrad, who sit down beside you, bending his blooded axe on his leg. You turn to him to reply, but before you can answer, he continues. Bernard, dead. The slit is short. He was a good man and a damn good leader, but all it took was one mistake. That makes you the one in charge now, don't it? Wendell joined the two of you, still breathing heavily, then Espen. Save the ceremony and the anointment for another day. Let's give the men a good burial and return to Finsterwald to collect our pay. The Weasel's men are slain after all. Beside, Captain, we ought to see to that wound before we lose you, too. We wouldn't want to leave Wendell in charge, right? So be it. Let's go. Okay, so where do we go from here? We've got our city here, so we need to just run back here. Oh, I'm in post. Okay, let's just go that way. Hopefully we won't be attacked. I would prefer avoid going into the wood, as it could be the home of some goblins. Who knows? Let's just pause the game for a sec, because I want to take a look at the map. It was already pretty big at the time. It seems to be even bigger. We've got a few different realms, which are going to be probably, if not at war with each other, which are going to have different kind of relationship together, and we'll probably be able to take contract for some which are going to be against others. So we'll see that bit later. Let's just try to reach. I've got two cities around, so we might want to do contract between these two to begin with. But let's first reach this down. I need to get a bit of money and replenish my team. The return of Finsterwald. What a sorry display it must be for the onlooker as you arrive in Finsterwald. Four blooded and bitten mercenary down on their luck. The man who hired the company days ago, Wenzel, the treasurer, no doubt expected you to return in a more glorious fashion. Still, he welcomes you to his house and offers bread and wine while a servant fetch a healer. A few words are exchanged except for the occasional grunt and wheeze as an elderly man with a shaky hand tends your wounds. A pin pierces your skin, the first of many stitches to come. You grit your teeth till you think you hear one break. Wenzel, the treasurer, sit beside you and ask if you took care of Hogarth. You shake your head. We killed his men, but the weasel eluded our blade in the end. The healer's waves around and a glowing fire poke, suggesting he want to push it into your wound. You nod and does so. For a moment, That's all there is. You're not a man, but a pinch of fire, flesh from flame, a golem of pain. Wenzel, the treasures, and your goblet of wine. We did well, sweat sellswords. The brigands have been removed, though it is a shame that Hogarth still lives. We expect to get paid for this. Wenzel, the treasure gasps. Well, naturally, 400 crowns as agreed upon. He gestures toward a servant who rushed to your side with the pay in hand. I wonder, may I make use of your service one more time? I'd be very much like to end the edict that is Hogarth once and for all. And I would pay for you again. Of course, another 400 crowns, shall we say. Conrad scoffs and turns to drink more wine, but Espen stands to speak. Yes, the company is in ruin, but we will rebuild it. Without the Seven of Odessa, Conrad would drink the crown away and end up begging in the streets. And Wendell, by the gods, we all know he'd go chasing the woman folk until one stove his rotten head in. We need the Seven of Odessa. It's all we have. What do you say, Captain? Conrad burps and raises cap to you. Wendell playfully thumbs his nose and nods. Kill that bastard Hogarth, and or not, it's up to you, Captain. Okay, so we have unfinished business with Hogarth. Let's go for it. It's going to give us a little aim to begin with. So Wenzel the Treasures claps his hand in satisfaction. Excellent, my little birds will need some time to find where Hogarth is hiding now. In the meantime, I suggest you see about stocking up on supply so that you'll be good and ready to end this when this time comes. I shall see you in a few days' time at the latest. As you leave, Wenzel the Treasures house and stand on the outskirts of Finsterwald, Espen seeks a word with you. We need more men, Captain. I know I gave a big speech back there, but bravado won't do shit. We need more warm body in the rank. Figure we find three good men, buy them some decent weapons, and dress them in the best armor can afford. The man paused to glance around. I bet this podunk town got a desperate peasant or two looking for a new life. Or we could travel to Waldane in the south. Some city folk aren't always as hardy as these country bumpkins, but we are more likely to find men with fighting experience stopping to rest there. Okay, we'll get a bunch of options. That's what we shall do. Okay, it is great, quite good. You don't want to go through the dialogue too quickly because it's really well written. I really like it. So what do we want to do here? We can hire a bunch of peasants here, which are going to give us the strength we need, or we could go south. Let's just leave for a sec, pause the game, and just take a look. So where is the city we're speaking about? Waldane, it's not too far, but it's going to make us cross the forest, and I think I might be better with a bunch of people to protect us. If we don't have... I wonder. So... is it Waldane south? Okay, we might want to try to do it nonetheless. It is the beginning, so taking a little bit of risk should not be doing too much harm. Hopefully we'll survive. We've got only three men with us. Can I just take a look at the inventory here? So we've got these three. They are not really happy currently. And let's see. What kind of equipment do I have? I've got a bit of grain, I've got a bunch of bandages, and I've got a wooden flail, which is a very bad weapon, I believe. Okay, let's just take a look at the perks. I think there is more than before. So many perks here. And do you have any points to spend? Level 1. Going to level up soon. And let's see. Can I choose something? No perk point to spend. No, I cannot. Let's just go back to stash and let's get out of there. Okay, spiderwoods. I expect spiderwoods to be filled with spiders. And there is a little animal here which is coming toward us. It would be better if we were to be avoiding that for a while. Okay, let's see. Can I just reach Waldane or not? Okay, I feel like we should be fine. As Waldane skyline appear on the horizon, Wenzel seeks a word with you. Never been to Waldane before, but I've been around one that look a lot like it. Cities like these are great for selling goods, as all these prissy pompous pricks love to have their goods delivered. With so many merchants, you can find almost everything you need too. Keep an eye out for bargains, and don't get swindled by them cutthroats merchants. relatively fit to add his own opinion of what you should do. If there is a good tavern, I say that's where we should go first. Nothing helps a man down on his luck more than a good pint. God knows we earned it, so we'll need to get this morale up again. Wendell shakes his head. You say that every time we stop into town. You say that even when you're already drunk. I'll keep that in mind. Okay, let's just read that down quickly and see what we can do. Alright, so we've got the marketplace, we've got the tavern. I'm going to make a brief stop at the tavern to get my people better. Or I could maybe hire a few people first. I wonder. I just pay around for my mill. It's going to cost me 20 when it's not much. And Wendell is now in good spirits. Okay, good. Let's just take a look. So we've got a marketplace, we've got a few people to hire, and there is a quest here. Villagers are disappearing here. I believe there might be something in the wood. So let's just take a look. We've got two people. We've got Cunald, which is, let's see, picking up his trade from a long lineage of strong-sighted forefathers. Cunald is a fletcher and a bowyer. So we've got a good archer here. But after so many years of making weapons for others, he began to wonder what else there was to life beside wooden strings. With his interest in bow making gone, can the former bowyer shoot arrows as well as he makes them? Okay, let's just hire the guy. And who's the second one? So, Ilderich. Chilled by dark events in the world, Ilderich stopped studying plants and began recording human history. With so many mercenary bands floating around, the Eastern sought to attach himself for some real-life studying. Ilderich has little in common with actual soldiers, but his imaginative mind fancies a good battle nonetheless. Okay, it's not where would I hire, but I've got very little doors here, so we're going to try to go with these. And let's just take a look, what kind of weaponry do we have here? We've got a bowman here with a short bow, and my other new character, Ilderich, has very little. So we're going to check what we can buy. Let's just take a look. So, marketplace, what are they selling? So I'm going to probably focus on shields, because I want to keep these guys alive long enough so they can actually level up. But what do we need? We've got a bit of money, so we should be fine. But let's see. So do I want to go maybe with axe? I want shield, that's sure. So let's just buy this shield here. Alright, we are going to be in need of a weapon as well. So woodcutter axe, damage 35-70. Let's just check with these. So we've got hatchet as well. But these are damaged, seemingly. Okay, let's go for the regular axe here, it seems to be good enough. And let's see if I can equip it properly on that guy. Okay, let's go with the shield, let's go with... Okay, it's a two-handed axe. Okay, not perfect, let's just go back to the shield. I'm going to keep it nonetheless, it will be useful for maybe another guy, like Conrad. He's using the pretty same one. So we'll be... It will be a spare weapon if we are in trouble. It is a bit of a waste, but not so much. So what do I want to give my buddy? One-handed. This is what I'm looking for. So let's check for the best one. Might be this one here. Okay, and now I need to find a bit of equipment, because I've got people which are not well equipped. So let's go for a padded leather, I think. And probably I should go with one of these full leather cap or two. Alright, let's go back to this. It's going to cost me a bit, but we might want to keep a bit of money nonetheless. Oh, let's go for the padded one. I don't think this is going to be as good. Linen tunic, no, not going to do it. And is this cap any good? Okay, it's slightly better, but I'm going to check if my other soldiers are... Nope, let's go for it. Okay, so... I just want probably to buy a little knife. Or I could... Can I carry a second weapon like this? Okay, it will be walking. Okay, good. It's far from perfect, but it is going to work nonetheless. I could... Do I want to buy something else? Or are we fine? I think for now we might be fine because I don't really have so much money. I'm going to try to find a quest here. And we'll see what we can do. Let's just sell this one. It's not worth much, but... It's taking a bit of space. I'm going to keep this one just in case. Okay, what is this quest about? So villages have been disappearing from this town. Can I get an int? A Fletcher. Oh, what can I do with a Fletcher? Okay, he's selling good equipment. Do I want to get something better than what I've got? Oh, let's see. What kind of bow am I using with my people? So I've got a crossbow, a light crossbow here, and a short bow. So 30, 50 in here. 30, 50 as well. Let's just take a look at what I can buy. Or maybe what I cannot buy. A light crossbow. Okay, no, I'm not going to do it. These are basically the same. Do I have any arrows available in my stash? Not too much. I might want to probably pick a bunch. Yep, it's going to be necessary. So let's go for a bunch of ammunition. And I want to pick a good one. So these ones are arrow bolt javelin. What do we have? Quiver of arrows. Okay, I think there is a difference. This one are to be equipped on people. And this one are probably going to be about to refill our supply. So useful. Don't want to go for more than that. 50 should be well enough for now, I think. Okay, do we have... Let's buy a bit of food also. A bit of ham and roots and berries. I wonder, I could go for more bandages maybe, but... Okay, I don't really want to waste my money too much right now because we might be in trouble. So let's just keep going with that. I've got probably enough. Okay, let's buy a bit of these. It will be fine. And where do I get this quest? You have already a contract. Okay. So I've got a few days. I've got... I still lack one more man. And I will not have enough money to equip it anyway. Oh. Got new people here. Nope. No, peasant have been disappearing, I think. But I cannot do much, can I? Just take a look. Okay, let's go back. So, I still don't know. I just cannot take more quests than that, I think. I'll just take a look at the tavern and let's see what kind of remote can get here. 807 of Edessa. Remember me from Finster World? We talk about, well, I don't really remember, but here we are. Let's drink. How have you been faring? Okay, so what I should do is to go back to Finster World. And hopefully we'll be fine. We might be... Oh, no, these are my prints, I think. Probably a bunch of wolves around. Oh, peasant here. They're doing the road here. Okay, maybe these were the one I've been spotting before. There is patrols as well. Good for us. Okay, they're crossing the woods as well. We are back. Okay, I'm going to hire one more guy, even though it seems to be a bit... Okay, let's go for that guy, we'll have three then. This is my first quest. Okay, should be fine. So one of the treasures is pacing back and forth when you find him. The healer who damn near killed you with the firebolt is standing nearby. He's picking a chunk of dried blood out of his fingernails. One of the treasure claps his hand. Finally, you're here. I have good news. We got hold of one of Hogarth's former men. My good friend here had a nice little talk with the man, and now I know where Hogarth, licking his wound. The healer clears throat, splaying his finger out like a maiden looking at to pen them. He speaks as though he's identifying a disease he's about to excise. The brigand known as Hogarth is hiding in a small hut on the hill to the northeast of here. Based upon my most civil discussion with one of these men, Hogarth knows seven of Odessa is on his heel and will have gathered more men since the last time you met him. Nodding, when did the treasures wave you off? Okay, so we need to go northeast. Good luck, Seltzward. We'll return with his head. We'll try at least. Okay, so let's just pause the game for a sec and let's just check where our quest is going to lead us. Just over there. Okay, so let's just approach carefully. Because I need this money. It's not much. I've been spending much more than that recently, so I will need to be careful where I spend my money. But we might be able to find a bit of loot on these guys. What do we have here? Can I just check? This is a battle site. I believe it is even where I lost most of my men in the beginning. Okay, let's see. I wonder how much enemy we're going to find here. So there is a few brigand tags and a brigand poacher, which might be our enemy or guard. So let's just engage and see what we're going to be able to do here. Okay, four of these guys, one with a bow and other with fairly decent equipment. So we've got Hogarth here, plus a brigand with an axe, 200 axe, another one with a flail and a shield, and that, okay. Okay, so how do I want to deal with that? How far can I shoot? Okay, so who do I want to begin with? I think I might want to begin with a bowman. I might the one in front of him, but this is a risk I'm willing to take. Alright, good. Let's just reload. Maybe I should have moved before doing that. Okay, well, he failed. Good for us. We need to keep elevated ground, I think. So, I've got somebody with a spear here. Let's just bring him here. We're going to go into a spear wall mod. Do I want to go with a shield wall first? Let's go with a shield wall because I don't want the bowman to do us too much harm. Okay, so that guy, let's just let him do his turn here. Okay, they are moving quite a bit. I didn't expect them to be able to go so quickly forward. Let's go over there. We're going to go into, let's see. Don't want to use knockback. Don't want to attack them right away. There is no element here, so I might be able to do a bit of damage. Let's just try to do it. So how much chance do I have to hit him? 46. It's not much, but let's try. And I cannot attack another time, so let's just end this turn and see what I can do. So I've got another guy with an axe. Don't really want to take too much risks here, so... But I want to protect the bowman though, so I'm going to just go on the right here. Alright. Okay, not where I wanted to go, but it will do. And I don't have enough point to actually attack again. Okay, let's just try to... I cannot move. Come on, buddy. Okay, seemingly I cannot do it, so let's just not go any further. And let's see what I can do with that guy. I don't really see so much here. This area seems to be a bit difficult to see. Here we go, I should not allow that guy to go through. And I could also maybe try to stun him. Okay, well, it's done. I'm going to move my bowman a bit on the right so I don't eat any of my people. Five, how much do I need to shoot? Four, okay, let's just try not to go too far. And a bit too far. Let's just try. No. Let's just go for Hogarth then. I've got 5% chance to eat, it's not really good. there. Let's try to move a bit further. Let's try again there. 5%. It's not really a good chance. Let's maybe not shoot. 8%. Nah. Okay, let's try to hit the guy. Okay, I failed quite a lot. And let's advance a bit. I don't have any more points. Let's just end the turn and see what they're going to do. Okay, so now I've got my crossbowman with... Oh! Rank button. Not cool. I failed completely at that. Okay, anyway, let's just take a look. So, speed shield could be useful. I could dispose of this shield right away. But I might want to try to kill him instead because I want to recover the shield. If I can. So no more attack. Okay, let's just call it a day. I'm not going to keep my finger on the F button because I've been losing a turn like this. Okay, so who do I want to finish? I think I might want to go with this guy. He's almost killed, so he might be easier. Alright. And let's go and try to attack the other one. Okay, much better. But I should maybe have splitted the killer to make more XP with those guys. So 28%, not much. Let's go for the aimed shot. It's a bit better. Okay, the shield got the most of it. I'm going to try to go and put myself in between. Okay, which is not possible, but good enough. Okay, I've got one guy which is going to be able to go in between. There we go. I'm going to try to stun the other guy, which has worked, surprisingly. And let's just take a look. Can I shoot the guy here? Ah, I've got one chance out of two. Not bad. Oh, he's down. Let's just go around while going to flank the other guy. And I might want to be careful not to go too far. Okay, I would prefer to put people with shield in front of the guy. Alright, let's go with... Do I want to knock him back? Not just necessary, let's just go for a little bit of this. I cannot attack anymore, so let's just pass my turn. And what if I was to go, let's say, over there? I will still have enough to shoot? Nope, I cannot go that far. Let's just go here. Nah, not worth it. Let's just move backward. Here we go. And I should have enough to attack him one more time. I've got a good axe, so against the shield it should be working fine. Let's just try to knock him out again. Very well. So he won't be able to attack. And I'm going to move a bit that way. And my turn. Enemy retreat, but they are kind of stunned. Okay, let's just try to not let them escape. I'm going to get his head if possible. I'm not going to let him retreat. Let's just try to finish him in time. And no more. Okay, nice. So I've got Eldritch, which has taken most of the XP. Conrad has taken one kill. Wendell one kill, and all the other one have regular XP. Okay, let's just take a look. What kind of loot do we have? You don't want to forget to take the loot, as it is going to be a very good way to replenish your equipment. We've got clothes rolls, plenty of food, a bit of money, tools, ammunition, and weapons and stuff. Let's just loot everything and leave. Okay, good. Hogarth lies dead in a pool of his own blood, skewered into a grotesque and panicked pose. He didn't weasel his way out of this one. He put a boot on his corpse and looked to your men. For the company, for all the men who've fallen. Wendell spit on the dead man's face. Let's take his bastard head and get back to Finstonwald. Time to get paid. Alright, let's go. 400 is not going to do much, but hopefully it will help us a bit. Okay, along the way, Wendell joined your side. Got a moment, Captain? You nod for him to speak his mind. The battle has left some gear worse for wear, and some men got a good nicking too. We can patch up both men and equipment while marching, but it's a lot faster to sit down and do it. Of course, if we make camp, we should be wary of ambush. A campfire in this part can be seen from every which ways. I'll keep that in mind. Let's just make a brief stop to actually give stuff to people. I've got one people which is not really well equipped. He has a tree limb. Let's just go for maybe a flail, it would be much more efficient. It needs to be repaired though. It is at 52%. Let's give him a wooden shield as well. And maybe a linen tunic would be a bit better than his... Oh, it's leather though. It is basically the same here. Let's just switch. Going to be a bit better, but not much. And let's give a knife to let's see, where is my bowman? Oh, he has an axe. Okay, let's just give a knife to this guy. If he's in trouble, he will be able to switch the flail for the knife. We'll repair that a bit later, but I could repair it now. I think I need to put it in the bag before I repair this. Oh, wrong. Okay, we'll see that later on. I did not check the perks though. Let's go back. So who's going to be able to... So everybody seems to be level 1. So there is no perk point to spend, and Wendell is going to be soon level 2, but not yet. I just speed up a bit. Alright. The return of Finsterwald. The company returns to Finsterwald as victors. The heads held much higher this time. The Sevens of Odessa are not the size that they once were, but they are still a force to be reckoned with, as Hogarth learned in his final moments. You carry his head in a sack that you empty in front of Wenzel the treasure's feet. He jumps back, but the healer quickly picks the head up, stares at it, and nods. Wenzel the treasure's approaches the brigand's bearded face and eyes it carefully. Yes, that is ugly mug, all right. Servant, bet this man his money. Gun in hand, you raise your voice to the men. As long as there is blood coursing through our veins, as long as we can hold swords and shields, there shall stand our company. All through the realm, people will know the Servant of Odessa. The man's shears, Espen put his hand on your shoulder. You did well, Captain. No matter where you lead us, the men will follow you as brothers in battle. So we get a bunch of crowns as brothers. Alright, is it already winter? There is nothing here to be done. It is night time, so we might want to establish a little camp. Let's just take a look at how we can do that. I think there is a little icon here. So camp, here we go. And now we can wait for the... Dead rays. Okay, let's move out. Just take a look. Do I want to repair things right away? No, everything is repaired. Good. So we are ready for battle. I just need to find a quest. I think we might want to go back to the other town because there was something about villager disappearing, and it is quite important to give us a little. Objective here. Okay, during camps, you feel good today, ready to lead the Seven of Odessa through any challenge to come. You gather the men around, kicking a span to his feet and telling Conrad to finish scrapping away the air on his neck letter. When their muttering has subsided, you start to address them. What do you tell the men the company will do? So we shall get the company's strength back to 12 men. It will make us a formidable force again. So this is basically some kind of objective we need to assign to ourselves. Formidable force again, and will allow us to take more profitable walks. We need ally, forging a bond of friendship and trust with one of the town will get the company better price. I think I might want to go for that one. Because we are going to try to make a bit of contracts around here. We've got something to do in Wilder. Well then, let's go. Hopefully we'll get a quest over there. I should also go and check Bremingwald when I can. Okay, there is some beasts in the forest. Direwolves, I'm pretty sure it's a bad idea to fight them. They are faster than we are. Are they not? I wonder if I can hide in the den or not. Anyway, let's just check if I can do something about that, because if I was to fight these, I might be better with more stuff. Okay, I've got a slightly bit of money, but not too much. Let's see, can I maybe get a quest here? Am I not? Yes, I think I might be able to do it. So, Alstein of Walden, listening to the talk of a few peasants when you find him. When they see you, they quickly depart, leaving the man with a satchel in hand. He holds it up. There's crowns in there. Crowns that those people are giving me to give someone, anyone, to help us. People are disappearing, sellsword, and when they are found, they are not just dead, but mangled and mutilated. Everyone is too scared to go anywhere. He stares into the sack, then look to you. I do hope you are interested in this task. Let's talk. Pay. He opened the palm of his hand. I'm tight on crowns, so before you ask, this is all I have right now. You'll be paid 80 crown in advance, and another 310 when the job is done. So what do I want to do here? Let's see, I'm going to accept the offer. Hopefully it will increase our reputation a bit more. So I need to hand down what's the rise wild, and it might be the werewolf, so it is fitting, I think. Alright, let's just accept that. And before we go, let's just try to find a slightly bit more equipment, because I might want to go for something a bit better for my guys. Do I have any? There is a sick tonic here, which might be good. I would prefer to go with the padded leather, even though it's a bit more heavy. And I still need to repair it also. I just take it. Alright, good. Do you want to go for bludgeon? I will find some of these at some point. Let's just check my men. Okay, so that guy here, Gizbert. He will need to get something a bit better, so let's just give him the padded leather. It's going to be much better than the linen tunic, I hope. We'll just need to repair it at some point, but it will be alright. And before we go any further, let's just make a brief stop at the tavern and give the men a little bit of courage here. Alright, so we can actually fight the werewolf before we get in trouble. Okay, you are being attacked. Yes, I know. So you can't make out with... it is werewolf, I know that. Let's just go to arms. So I'm pretty sure it's not an opponent which is going to be easy to deal with. Okay, my three of these. Not cool. I knew it, but not cool nonetheless. So, what can I do against these guys? I've got 10% chance. It's not much. More chance here. 39, but much better. Let's go for this one. I failed. I could have... Let's just reload that. Okay, so let's bring my spearmen a bit further. And let's try to knock back this thing. It's going to cost me 4. And if I want to go into spear wall, it's not going to be possible. I could still try it. Here he goes. Good, let's go like that. We've got somebody to... So I've got 3 shields. I'm going to try to use them to delay a bit the attack on my people. So there is not going to be any. So it's going to cost me a bit, but let's go. And then let's try to use my axe to weaken the beast quite quickly. Oh, come on. They are quite fast. I should have known that. Okay, so how do I want to deal with that? I'm going to bring maybe my guy here. Maybe not, because the Gilbert is not really going to be in any a position to protect us. Let's go and bring that guy here. It will wait. And can I shoot maybe the beast? I just try to do as much damage as possible. So 44, 48, and no. Okay, let's try to go for this one. I did not actually touch this one, so there is no reason for me to not go for this one. Come on, buddy, it was so close. And let's just fall back a bit. No! What have I done? Oh, crap. I thought I was still moving the guy with the shield. Not good. Not good at all. Okay, these opponent art of the might put us in danger. Okay, I failed. So, can we shoot that guy? 10%. Okay, there is very little chance for us to do that, but I might want to move my bowman here. Can I not go there? Nope. And if I'm here, I cannot really shoot anybody, do I? 10%. No, it's not worth it. Just not do it then. And let's try to take care of that one. Come on, I failed again. But I can try another time. I've got 36% chance to damage them. Okay, good. Let's just bring that guy with the shield as close as possible. It's going to be a bit in between, which is very bad. Oh no, my mistake. It is bad for him, so I'm going to use my advantage to use the flail. So I've got 2 attack. And... oh, with this one I can actually just... I've got 100% chance to hit the head. Might be what I'm looking for. Okay, good. And let's go and try to keep pushing on the same one. Okay, let's try again. Okay, we need to keep going on this one. And I might want to fall back with my guy here. Oh, crap. Come on, just try to... yes, good. So they won't be able to come any closer to that guy. If that guy old, I might be able to finish up. Okay, so let's see. I'm going to climb here so I get a better view. And we'll try to shoot some people. So 13 and 55. Okay, let's go for this one. Nice. He's going to flee at some point. So we won't be able to go much further here with this guy. And let's try... I'm going to focus on this one. There is no reason for me to move on anybody else. Crap. No luck. Let's keep pushing on that one. Again. Alright, it's working a bit. And what if I'm using this attack again? It's going to cost me only 4. So it might be working well. And with the regular one... okay, it's done. So I might want to keep, you know, being a bit more defensive here. So I'm going to survive a bit more. Alright, good. Can I just use my axe as well? Okay, good. With aim shot, can I avoid hitting my buddy? No, I cannot. So we're going to stick around. I'm going to try to give me a bit more range, though, so they don't come and kill me. Okay, fine. We're alive. And oh yes, I can maybe make... I can reload. Oh, come on. It's going to cost me 7 AP. So I can still shoot. Fine. Okay, let's try it. Good. And can I try to finish this one? I've got a round swing, but it's really unnecessary, so I'm not going to use it. A spirit shield is going to be very unnecessary as well, so let's go for the regular jack here. And I failed again. No. Maybe I should just go for a weapon which is going to be a bit lighter. But I believe this one is going to do a lot of harm, but I should be able to eat first. Okay, let's go. I've got 4 AP for this one. You know what? I might want to be careful with this. Okay, let's go with this. Okay, this one is going to stay defensive here. And that guy here is going to try to finish this beast. Okay, not going to happen. I've got enough point, don't I? Stand. Let's go for it. So we need to go for the head first. Well, it is going to be easier to get the direwolf now. And let's go for a regular attack here. Okay, we are taking damage here. We need to finish this fight quickly, or we'll be in trouble. Let's reload and shoot. Almost done. Near death, good. Let's try to use this axe again. I will, yes, good. Cannot do more, but it will be good enough. Nope, you don't. And now I should be able to maybe finish him with my spear. Maybe not. Maybe not. Done. No more. Maybe I should just... Nah, I cannot move anymore. Let's use the flay to try to finish this beast. Okay, no more. No more action point. Let's just try to finish them. Not going to let them flee. They've been doing too much damage already. Too little chance. Let's not do it. I'm going to keep him for later. Let's just try to finish the beast. Okay, no more. Good, so we are still alive. We've been able to kill 3 opponents. I should have Eldritch, which is going to level up, plus a few more, as a matter of fact. So let's just take a look at the loot. We've got Wolf Belt, which might be selling for a bit. And we've got a level up to deal with. So first thing first, let's just make the camp here. We are going to also take a look at our stuff. How damaged are we? We need to repair everything, it seems. Is this one any good? 25. Let's just switch. It should be probably repairing a bit faster in equipment slots like this. And just take a look at the perks. We've got 3 people which are able to use perks. We've got to level up here. Let's just take a look. So we need to choose. We've got 3 points to spend. And we need to make our people tougher. So let's see. Maximum fatigue. It's very important because you're not going to be able to fight as well if you are not having enough. But you might want to be careful not to take too much damage. So you might want to focus on defense first. If we got a pretty high melee defense, it will be enabling us to actually do more. So, alright, plus 2 here. And maybe I should go for a bit more damage as well. So I'm playing with Eldritch, which seems to be the one at which I used to kill the most. So let's just go and give him a bit more punch. And let's go for a bit more fatigue, maybe. Alright. And do I have a perk? Yes, I do have 1 perk to spend. So let's take a look at what we can actually buy right now. Fast adaptation. So gain an additional stacking of 8% chance to hit with each attack that misses an opponent. This is pretty good. Let's just check. But it's especially good for people which have 200 arcs, I believe. Crippling strikes. Cripple your enemy. Lower the threshold to inflict injury by 33% for both melee and ranged attack. Not what I'm looking for. Oh, hit points are increased by 25%. This one is quite good. Colossus. Do we have other thing? 9 lives. 1 spare battle upon receiving a killing blow. Survive instead of with a few hit points left. Pretty good as well. Bag and belts. Unlock 2 extra bag slots. It's probably going to be better for bowmen or something like that. Pathfinder. Learn to move on difficult terrain, so we'll be able to move a bit better. So action point cost for movement and all terrain is reduced by 1 to a minimum of 2 action points per tile. Okay, so this one is also probably going to be very useful for bombers. Adrenaline unlocks adrenaline skill, which puts you first in turn order for the next round to have another turn before your enemy does. This one is really powerful as well. Recover unlocks the recover skill, which allow for resting a turn in order to reduce accumulated fatigue by 50%. Okay, this one is really, really good. And the last one, student. Everything can be learned if you put your mind to it. Gain additional 20% experience from the battle. I think this one is something you might want to go for really, really early, so you gain the most of it. Let's go for this one. I might want to take it for all our characters, even though it's not going to help me right away. In the long run, I'm pretty sure it's going to be a huge boost. So let's give it to Espen as well. At the 11 character level, you gain an additional perk points, and this perk becomes inert. So yes, you want to take this perk very early, as it's going to be working only for the 11th first level. Okay. Okay, I've got a few more points to spend, so let's just take a look at Espen. What do we want to go for? Well, it seems there is a stat which needs to be increased first. Let's just check on somebody else, just to be sure. Let's go on to Bowman to see if it is the same or not. Oh, it is not. So I need to focus on this one, I believe, to be able to make a team which is going to be strong enough. So let's just give them a bit of these. Alright, so more fatigue, more health point, and more morale. Resolve. So it's going to be our willpower and bravery. Okay. So that guy here needs a bit more melee defense, a bit more damage as well, and a bit more resolve, so let's go for this. And my bowman here is requiring more damage with bows, which is given. A ranged defense, because he will normally not be too close to enemies. And initiative, so we are going to be able to attack probably. Let's take a look. Initiative is reduced by the current fatigue, as well as any penalty to maximum fatigue. I think it's going to give me the ability to shoot first, maybe. And no more points spent, so let's just go for it. Alright, so let's go back to the town and see what we can do. So I need to sell a few things, and I still don't have a clue for this quest. So we'll just go and sell a few pelt and see how much money we're going to get for it. Oh, not so much, but still, it is not bad. If compared to what we are winning for a quest. So what do we want to go for? So this town is producing wood, seemingly. So I might be able to trade a bit, maybe to bring the wood somewhere else. It's costing quite a bit, though. I want to check how much it's selling. Oh, it's quite expensive here. I'm buying it for a lot, so maybe I should just find another town which is going to be selling it for a lot less. I like the fact that they are telling me how much things are worth, and so I can see the difference of what I'm paying for. Okay, good. I will need to repair stuff. And do I want to add more men? I don't think so, because it's going to cost me a bit too much, and I don't really have the money to do so. Alright. Okay, guys, I don't think we are going to be able to go any further today, but this game seems to be, you know, a bit less cruel to you in the beginning. It's letting you just discover the game a bit more, even though the fights are still pretty rough, and I'm in a pretty easy mode to begin with. I believe there is still plenty to discover, so I will probably go for another video to give us a bit more information about how this game is going to unfold. So guys, thank you for watching, I hope you liked the video. If you do, please leave a like, a comment, or subscribe. And I'll see you next one, guys. Have fun!